Hi students, good morning. In this episode, we are going to discuss the problems based on product rule of differentiation. So first question, minimum 5 to 6 models based on this product rule of differentiation we have to discuss. The first problem, find the derivative of, like this they will ask the question, find the derivative of the function x square minus 3 into 4x cube plus 1. First function you have to assume that u, second function you have to assume that v. First function is u, second function is v. So the product of these two functions, let us consider either y or f of x. If we consider these two are f of x and g of x, you can consider an other name. So here u into v, so we know that d by dx of u into v, d by dx of u into v means u into d by dx of v plus v into d by dx of u. So here, this is u, this is v. Now differentiate with respect to x. I already said in previous classes, what is the meaning of dw or px? Differentiate with respect to x. So y derivative with respect to x. So dy by dx, which is equal to, now I am going to apply for this product of these two functions, this formula. So u into x square minus 3 into d by dx of v, 4x cube plus 1 plus v into 4x cube plus 1 into d by dx of u. D by dx of u means what? X square minus 3, which is equal to x square minus 3 into, keep bracket, d by dx of 4x cube. So 4 constant you can take outside, d by dx of x cube plus d by dx of constant 1. In the coming steps, in this first question I am explaining each and every term. After that I went directly. Plus 4x cube plus 1 into, keep bracket, d by dx of x square plus d by dx, not plus here, minus d by dx of minus 3. That means 3 here, constant, which is equal to x square minus 3, 4 into d by dx of x power n formula, we know that. What is the formula for d by dx of x power n? D by dx of x power n is equal to n into x power n minus 1. So here n is equal to 3, 3 into x power 3 minus 1, that is 2. So 4 into 3x square plus d by dx of constant, d by dx of constant, any constant, it is 0. D by dx of constant is 0 plus 4x cube plus 1 into d by dx of x square. Again you have to apply this formula, 2 into x power 2 minus 1, that means 2x, minus d by dx of constant, that value is 0. Now simplify, 4 into 3x square is 12x square into x square minus 3 plus 2x into 4x cube plus 1. So actual multiplication you have to do here, 12x power 4 minus 12 into 3, 36x square plus 8x power 4 plus 2x, which is equal to 12x power 4 plus 8x power 4, 20x power 4 minus 36x square plus 2x, which is dy by dx. Like this you have to do the sum. Sometimes you have to approach in different way other than u into v. Instead of this formula, First, what we have to do, the given function is product of two functions, two polynomials. So, making into single polynomial and then differentiate directly, you will get the same answer. That's the second way. We'll collect that. Next, we'll take the next question. Next question. Y equal to root x plus 1 into x square minus 4x plus 2. So first, this is u, this is v. In next step, differentiate with respect to x. Y derivative is dy by dx. You have to apply this formula. U into root x plus 1 into d by dx of x square minus 4x plus 2 plus v into x square minus 4x plus 2 into d by dx of u root x plus 1. Now each and every term of this bracket value multiply differentiate by respect x. Root x plus 1 into d by dx of x square. From the next problem onwards, directly I'll write minus 4 constant you can take outside d by dx of x plus d by dx of constant 2 plus x square minus 4x plus 2 d by dx keep bracket d by dx of root x plus d by dx of 1. Therefore, root x plus 1 d by dx of x square. D by dx of x square means what? 2x. In previous question also we got it. D by dx of x power n is equal to n x power n minus 1. So, d by dx of x square is 2x. Minus 4 into d by dx of x. In place of n substitute 1. 1 into x power 1 minus 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. So, 1 into 0. It will come, x power 0 is 1. 1 into 1. So it will become d by dx of x is 1 plus d by dx of constant is 0 plus x square minus 4x plus 2 into d by dx of root x. In previous classes also I said that d by dx of root x is equal to 1 by 2 root x. You remember the standard formula it is d by dx of root x is equal to 1 by 2 root x plus d by dx of constant 1 0. So just you have to simplify all the terms. 2x minus 4 into root x plus 1 plus x square minus 4x plus 2 divided by 2 root x. Why? Because plus 0 is not considered directly this value. No need to simplify, give it like this. This model is important. Y is equal to ax plus b whole power n into cx plus d whole power m. Same you have to apply. Apply that UV formula. This is u, this is v. Differentiate with respect to x. Dy by dx equal to ax plus b whole power n into d by dx of cx plus d whole power m plus cx plus d, that is v into cx plus d whole power m into d by dx of ax plus b whole power n, which is equal to ax plus b whole power n, keep bracket, it is in the form of f of x whole power n. In previous class I said that the function is of the form f of x whole power n, n into f of x whole power n minus 1. Again f of x we have to differentiate. So d by dx of cx plus d whole power m means m into cx plus d whole power m minus 1. Again cx plus d we have to differentiate. D by dx of ax plus b is what? X coefficient I said. A. So d by dx of cx plus d is what? C. This bracket completed. Come to the next term. Cx plus d whole power m into, again you have to apply same formula. D by dx of f of x whole power n. N into f of x whole power n minus 1, that means ax plus b whole power n minus 1 into d by dx of ax plus b. D by dx of ax plus b is a. Just you have to simplify. A m into c, mc or cm. Ax plus b whole power n into cx plus d whole power m minus 1 plus n into a, na or an. C cx plus b whole power m into ax plus b whole power n minus 1. No need to simplify, leave it like this. Next question. Y equal to e power 2x into log of 3x plus 4. Again, you have to consider this is u, this is v. Differentiate with respect to x on both sides generally. Y derivative is dy by dx, which is equal to, first you have to write in this form, further 1 mark out of 2 marks. So u into e power 2x into d by dx of v. V means log of 3x plus 4. Plus v into log of 3x plus 4 into d by dx of u. U means e power 2x, which is equal to e power 2x into, keep bracket, it is in the form of log f of x. D by dx of log x is what? 1 by x. D by dx of log 3x plus 4 is 1 by 3x plus 4. We cannot stop there. Again, 3x plus 4 you have to differentiate. So d by dx of log of 3x plus 4 is 1 by 3x plus 4 into d by dx of 3x plus 4 is 3. Why? Because we have formula d by dx of ax plus b. D by dx of ax plus b is equal to a. I said already. And d by dx of log f of x, 1 by f of x. Again, d by dx of f of x, you have to do that. These two formulas we are applying in this question. Now come to the next term, plus log of 3x plus 4 into d by dx of e power 2x. It is in the form of d by dx of e power x. D by dx of e power x is what? E power x. But in place of x, 2x is there, no? So what we have to do is d by dx of e power f of x. D by dx of e power f of x is e power f of x. Again, f of x you have to differentiate. So, d by dx of 2x, it will become 2. D by dx of 2x. Otherwise, you remember like this is a formula. D by dx of e power ax, which is equal to a into e power ax. Even if you apply this formula, here a is equal to what? D by dx of e power 2x. 2 into e power 2x. So, just you have to simplify, 3 into e power 2x divided by 3x plus 4 plus 2 into e power 2x divided by, into log of 3x plus 4. If you want to take common e power 2x from e power 2x from both the terms, it will become e power 2x into 3 by 3x plus 4 plus 2 into log of 3x plus 4. That's all answer. Like this you have to do that. More two problems based on this we can discuss. The next question. Y equal to 4 plus x square into e power 2x. See, this is u, this is v. So differentiate with respect to x on both sides. No need to write on both sides directly. Y derivative is dy by dx. Now, we have to apply u, v formula. U is 4 plus x square into d by dx of v, d by dx of e power 2x plus e power 2x, v into d by dx of u. U means x square plus 4 or 4 plus x square, which is equal to 4 plus x square into d by dx of e power 2x. Just now I said formula in previous question. D by dx of e power ax is a e power ax. Once again I write d by dx of e power ax, a into e power ax. This formula we are going to apply now. So a is equal to what here? 2. 2 e power 2x plus e power 2x into d by dx of x squared. It will become 2x. D by dx of 4 constant is 0. Therefore, 2 into e power 2x into 4 plus x square plus 2x into e power 2x. So, from these two, if you take common 2 e power 2x, it will becomes 4 plus x square plus x, which is the required answer.
This is the dy by dx value.
We take one more problem. The next question. Find the derivative of y is equal to a power x into e power x square. Again, we have to apply UV formula. Differentiate with respect to x. This is u, this is v. Dy by dx equal to u into a power x into d by dx of e power x square plus e power x square, that means v into d by dx of a power x, which is equal to a power x d by dx of e power x square. It is in the form of d by dx of e power f of x. E power f of x derivative is e power f of x. That means e power d by dx of e power x square is x square. Again, x square have to differentiate. D by dx of x square is equal to 2x plus e power x square into d by dx of a power x. Standard formula. A power x into log a to the base e. D by dx of a power x is a power x into log a to the base e. From these two, you have to take common a power x into e power x square. If you take common from both the terms, then you will get 2x plus log a to the base e. This is the value of dy by dx to the corresponding given y value. Next question. If f of x equal to e power x into x square plus 1, then find dy by dx. Or if the function is f of x, then find f dash of x. So this is u, this is v. Whenever you are assuming here f of x, you have to write it as df by dx or f dash of x. Differentiate with respect to x. D by dx of f of x is f dash of x. You have to remember, wherever d by dx of f of x if you are getting, that meaning is derivative of the function f dash of x. Instead of writing d by dx of f of x, directly we are writing as f dash of x, which is equal to u into e power x into d by dx of x power d by dx of x square plus 1 plus v into, v means what, x square plus 1 into d by dx of e power x, which is equal to e power x into d by dx of x square. D by dx of x square is 2x. D by dx of constant 1 is 0. Plus x square plus 1 into d by dx of e power x. E power x is the standard formula. From these two, e power x take common. E power x into 2x plus x square plus 1, which is equal to e power x into, this bracket value, if you want to write a square plus 2ab plus 1, you can write as x plus 1 whole square. This is f dash of x value to the corresponding given f of x. Come to the second one. The second one means here 8 1. If the question is asking in terms of f of x, again you have to consider u into v. Differentiate with respect to x. F dash of x is equal to u into e power 2x into d by dx of log x. In the coming problem, directly write, no need of writing d by dx. After getting some experience by doing sums, so directly you have to approach. That is the way of doing. E power 2x into d by dx of log x plus log x into d by dx of e power 2x, which is equal to e power 2x into d by dx of log x is 1 by x plus log x into d by dx of e power 2x. I already said that d by dx of e power x is what? A into e power x. So a is equal to 2. 2 into e power 2x. Now take common e power 2x from both the terms. E power 2x into 1 by x plus 2 log x. Therefore, f dash of x is equal to e power 2x into 1 by x plus 2 log x. In the next, we have to do that, the problem based on quotient rule of differentiation. Now,
the questions
which are based on quotient rule of differentiation. What is the quotient rule of differentiation? D by dx of u by v equal to v into d by dx of u minus u into d by dx of v by v square. So first, this is equal to u, this is u by v is in this form. So first, differentiate. If y is equal to a minus x by a plus x, then find dy by dx. Remove this and keep it as u by v, which is equal to u by v. Whenever it is in the form of u by v, differentiate with respect to x and apply the quotient rule of differentiation formula. Differentiate with respect to x. Y derivative is dy by dx. According to the formula, v squared in the denominator, that means a plus x whole squared. Next, v into, v means what? A plus x into d by dx of a minus x minus a minus x, that means u, u into d by dx of v, v means a plus x. In the first step, we applied that quotient rule of differentiation. Now we have to do that differentiation for the corresponding term. A plus x, keep bracket, d by dx of a constant, that constant derivative 0, minus d by dx of x is 1, minus a minus x into, keep bracket, d by dx of a constant is 0, plus d by dx of x is 1, whole divided by a plus x whole squared, which is equal to minus 1 into a plus x, minus a minus x. So 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 into minus of a minus x. So minus into a is minus a, minus into minus x is plus x, divided by a plus x whole square. So plus x minus x get cancelled, which is equal to minus 2a divided by a plus x whole square. Therefore, the derivative of the given function y is equal to a minus x by a plus x is dy by dx equal to minus 2a by a plus x whole square. Next question in quotient rule. If y is equal to px square plus 2x plus r by ax plus b, then find dy by dx. So this is u, this is v, obviously. Apply the differentiation formula, quotient rule of differentiation. Differentiate with respect to x, y derivative is dy by dx, which is equal to denominator square, that means v square, ax plus b whole square. Next, v into, v means what? Ax plus b into d by dx of px square plus qx plus r minus u into px square plus qx plus r into d by dx of v. V means ax plus b. Now formula application step completed. Next, differentiation step, which is equal to ax plus b. Observe carefully this step. P constant, the product of two functions are there. In this, p is constant. Whenever you are doing the differentiation, product of two terms are there, one among that, one of the term is constant. Constant you can take outside and the remaining term you have to differentiate. So p into d by dx of x square is 2x. Plus here also qx, q is constant. Q you can take this side, d by dx of x is 1. So q into 1. Plus d by dx of r constant, that value is 0. Minus px square plus qx plus r into, keep bracket, d by dx of ax, a into d by dx of x, 1, plus d by dx of b constant, 0, whole divided by ax plus b whole square. Now, simplification, 2x plus 2xp plus q, 2xp plus q into ax plus b minus a into what is a plus z is 0, a plus 0 equal to a into this complete value. So each and every term multiplying by a, it will becomes minus apx square minus aqx minus ar divided by ax plus b whole square in the next step. Each and every term multiplying by ax plus b, not compulsory, you have to do that. Ax into 2xp, that means 2ap into x square plus ax into q, ax cube or aqx, b into 2xp, 2bpx plus bq minus apx square minus aqx minus ar divided by ax plus b whole square plus aqx minus aqx will be cancelled, and 2apx square minus apx square, it will becomes dy by dx equal to 2apx square minus apx square is apx square. Next, 2bpx, 2bpx. Next, minus ar plus bq, bq minus ar divided by ax plus b whole square. That's all. Like this you have to do when it is in the form of u by v. The next question, third question. If y equal to ax plus b by cx plus d, this is already given in public examination. So you have to keep concentrate on this problem. Again you have to apply u by v formula. Differentiate with respect to x. Y derivative is dy by dx, which is equal to, apply u by v formula, v square in the denominator, v into cx plus d into d by dx of u numerator, ax plus b minus numerator into ax plus b into d by dx of denominator, cx plus d. Therefore, dy by dx equal to cx plus b into d by dx of ax plus b. In previous classes, I have given a shortcut formula. Whenever you are doing that linear function differentiation, d by dx of linear function, whatever the x coefficient is there, that only answer. So, d by dx of ax plus b, x coefficient is a directly. If you want to do regular method, d by dx of ax is a plus d by dx of b constant is 0. So, a plus 0 is a minus ax plus b into d by dx of cx plus d. As a shortcut formula, x coefficient is what here, c. So, d by dx of cx plus d is c divided by cx plus d whole square. Therefore, dy by dx equal to a into cx plus d, acx plus ad minus each and every time multiplying by minus a into c into ax, acx, cb into minus, minus bc divided by cx plus d whole square. So, minus acx plus acx. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to ad minus bc divided by cx plus d whole square. You apply this formula, you can use as a shortcut formula. See how to remember easily. Y is equal to, if y is equal to ax plus b by cx plus d, then dy by dx equal to, how to write easily means, here this ax plus b by cx plus d, we can write it as A 2 by 2 matrix A, B, C, D. What is the determinant of this matrix? AD minus BC only, no? If you are assuming this is capital A, that A is equal to AD minus BC only, no? What it is AD minus BC, determinant of this only, no? So easy to remember if it is AX plus B by CX plus B, if you are assuming as 2 by 2 matrix, then determinant we have to write AD minus BC divided by denominator whole square, CX plus D whole square, like this. You have to remember as shortcut formula. This one. Suppose, for example, if y is equal to 3x plus 2 divided by 7x plus 4, then find dy by dx. Even in regular exams also you can apply. So first find out the values of A, B, C, D. Given y equal to 3x plus 2 divided by 7x plus 4. A is equal to 3, B is equal to 2, C is equal to 7, D is equal to 4. Therefore dy by dx equal to AD minus BC by CX plus D whole square. Therefore dy by dx equal to AD minus BC. So 3 into 4, 12. Minus 2 into 7, 14. Divided by CX plus D, 7X plus 4 whole square. Therefore dy by dx equal to minus 2 by 7X plus 4 whole square. Please don't mind. I am writing in this way, just I have to tell for that. Okay? Now we are going to discuss regularly asking questions from differentiation. How they are going to ask, other than product rule and particularly product rule of differentiation, particularly quotient rule of differentiation, and the mixing problems with different questions we are going to discuss now. So again, the first question in the regular questions. If y equal to 5 sin x plus e power x into log x, then find dy by dx. Like this they will ask the question. So first what we have to do in the solution step, given y is equal to 5 sin x plus e power x into log x. First step. After writing the first step, what we have to do? Next step is differentiation step only. Differentiate with respect to x. Y derivative is dy by dx. After that, this is sum of two functions. First thing, differentiate with respect to x for both the functions. D by dx of 5 into sin x, each and every term you have to differentiate, plus d by dx of e power x into log x, which is equal to d by dx of 5 into sin x, 5 constant you can take outside, d by dx of sin x cos x, plus d by dx of e power x into log x. Here if you observe that this is product rule of differentiation, d by dx of e power x into log x. So first u into, apply differentiation of product rule, e power x into d by dx of log x plus log x into d by dx of e power x, which is equal to 5 into cos x plus e power x into d by dx of log x is 1 by x plus log x into d by dx of e power x is e power x, which is equal to 5 cos x plus, from these two e power x take common, e power x into 1 by x plus log x. That's all dy by dx. Like this you have to do that. We'll take one more problem. Second problem. If y equal to 5 power x plus log x plus x cube into e power x, then find dy by dx. So if y equal to 5 power x plus log x plus x cube into e power x. So here in the given y, total 3 terms are there. For every term you have to apply dy by dx. d by dx. After that you have to apply. For first function, direct one. Second one also, only single functions are there, first and second. But third term, it contains product of two functions. There you have to apply product rule. So now, so we will come to the general procedure. Given y equal to 5 power x plus log x plus x cube into e power x. After that, differentiate with respect to x. Y derivative is dy by dx, which is equal to d by dx of 5 power x. Each and every term of this side, you can apply d by dx. Differentiation of this function with respect to x plus d by dx of log x plus d by dx of e power x into x cube or x cube into e power x, which is equal to d by dx of 5 power x. In the earlier class, I told the formula d by dx of a power x is equal to a power x into log a to the base e. So here in place of a, what value is there? 5. So 5 power x into log 5 to the base e plus d by dx of log x, 1 by x, plus here I am going to apply direct UV formula, no need of writing u into d by dx of v plus v into d by dx of u. Already we did number of problems. So keep bracket and apply u into v formula. D by dx, first u into, that means x cube into d by dx of e power x. So e power x plus v into, v means e power x, d by dx of x cube. D by dx of x power n is what? N into x power n minus 1. So n is equal to 3 here. D by dx of x power 3 means 3 into x power 3 minus 1. That means 3x square. From these two, you can take common x square into e power x. So 5 power x into log 5 to the base e plus 1 by x plus x square into e power x. If you take common here, x will be remaining. Plus here 3 will be remaining. Therefore, the value of dy by dx equal to 5 power x into log 5 to the base e plus 1 by x plus x square into e power x into x plus 3. So if you take common here, x square into e power x, 1x will be there here. If you take common x square into e power x, the rest of the term is 3. We got this value. So anyway, here two important steps are there in differentiation. First thing, applying which formula according to the question. After that, for that particular formula also you have to remember, you have to know that to do the sums. Otherwise difficult differentiation will be difficult. If you know the formula as well as how to apply, where to apply, by practicing it will come. By practicing it will be easy. So differentiation is very easy if you follow the formula as well as by practicing. We'll go to next question. Shall we move? Yeah. Completed. This is question number 3. If y equal to e power x plus sin x into cos x, then find dy by dx. So first, given y is equal to e power x in plus sin x into cos x, differentiate with respect to x. Y derivative is dy by dx. Next, each and every term you have to differentiate. So d by dx of e power x plus d by dx of sin x into cos x. D by dx of e power x, we know that e power x plus, after that we have to apply u into v formula.
D by dx of u v.
So u into sin x into d by dx of cos x minus sin x plus v into cos x into d by dx of sin x cos x, which is equal to e power x minus into plus is minus sin x into sin x sin square x plus cos x into cos x cos square x, which is equal to e power x first plus term cos square x minus sin square x. In trigonometry we have formula cos square a minus sin square a equal to cos 2a. We have formula, it is. So cos square x minus sin square x is cos 2x, which is equal to e power x plus cos 2x. This is the value of dy by dx.
Shall we move to next question?
Yeah. The next question, this coming question is very, very important. If y equal to log of log x to the base 7, then find dy by dx. And find dy by dx.
Here the log of log x to the base 7.
First you have to write given y is equal to log of log x to the base 7. In logarithms we have a property, log a to the base b can be written as log a by log b. By using this formula, this function can be expressed as y equal to log of log x divided by log 7. Are you able to understand all of you? This is a, this is b. So log a to the base b can be written as log a by log b. So in the same way, log of log x divided by log 7. This function we are going to differentiate now. By observing, it is in the form of u by v. But in the denominator, if you observe log 7 is constant. So whenever it, we can treat as constant this, we can take separate. And the rest of the function you have to differentiate. So we can write it as y equal to 1 by log 7. Into log of log x, differentiate with respect to x. So y derivative is dy by dx, which is equal to 1 by log 7. Now differentiation of log x, we know that d by dx of log f of x, d by dx of log x is what? 1 by x. D by dx of log f of x is 1 by f of x. Again d by dx of f of x, you have to do that. So this procedure you have to do. So here also d by dx of log x is 1 by log x. After that what you have to do? Again d by dx of log x. You have to do that. Why? Because log x is the function involving in log x, which is equal to 1 by log 7 into log x into d by dx of log x is 1 by x. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to 1 by x into log 7. This is the answer for the given question.
This type of questions are important for 2 marks in the boards. Next, one other important question. If f of x equal to 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube plus and so on x power 100, then find f dash of 1. To calculate f dash of 1, we need to calculate f dash of x. So, first step, given function or simply given. Given function. F of x is equal to 1 plus x square plus x cube plus and so on plus x power 100. Differentiate with respect to x. F of x derivative is f dash of x is equal to constant 1 d by dx of constant 1 0 plus d by dx of x 1 plus d by dx of x square 2x d by dx of x cube 3x square plus d by dx of and so on d by dx of x power 100 100 into x power 100 minus 1 that means 99. This is the value of f dash of x. 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus and so on plus 100 into x power 99. But we want f dash of 1. So put x is equal to 1 in the above. F dash of 1 is equal to wherever x is there 1 will have to replace 1 plus 2 into 1 plus 3 into 1 square plus and so on plus 100 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on 100 the first sum of 100 terms we know that first sum of n terms sigma n is equal to n into n plus 1 divided by 2 but here n is equal to 100. So, n into n plus 1 divided by 2. Here n is equal to 100. So, 100 into 100 plus 1 divided by 2 which is equal to 2 ones are 250s. So, 50 into 101 which is equal to 50. Therefore, f dash of 1 is equal to 50. The next question. If f of x equal to 2x square plus 3x minus 5, then show that f dash of 0 plus 3 into f dash of minus 1 equal to 0. So, how it is? First, given function, f of x is equal to 2x square plus 3x minus 5. In the question, they are asking f dash of 0, f dash of minus 1. So, we need to calculate f dash of x. Differentiate with respect to x. F of x derivative is f dash of x is equal to 2 into 2 constant d by dx of x square 2x plus 3 constant you can take outside d by dx of x is 1 minus d by dx of constant is 0. Therefore f dash of x is equal to 2 into 2x is 4x plus 3. This is the value of f dash of x. Now calculate the values of f dash of 0 and f dash of minus 1. Put x is equal to 0 in equation 1. Therefore, it will becomes f dash of 0 is equal to 4 into 0 plus 3 which is equal to 0 plus 3 which is equal to 3. So, f dash of 0 equal to 3. Next, put x is equal to minus 1 in equation 1, wherever x is there, minus 1. F dash of minus 1 equal to 4 into minus 1 plus 3, which is equal to minus 4 plus 3, which is equal to minus 1. So f dash of minus 1 is equal to minus 1. Now come to the question. They are asking to prove this value equal to 0. Now consider f dash of 0 plus 3 into f dash of minus 1 equal to f dash of 0 is 3 plus 3 into f dash of minus 1 is minus 1. So 3 minus 3 which is equal to 0. Therefore f dash of 0 plus 3 into f dash of minus 1 is equal to 0. Like this you have to do that.
The last concept in this class is
the product of three functions you have to apply.
How to apply product of three functions?
Differentiation of product of three functions. See that d by dx of u into v into w, differentiation of the product of three functions where u, v, w are three differentiable functions, which is equal to, how to remember easily the product rule when three functions are given. D by dx of u into v into w equal to, first what you have to do, first function you have to differentiate, that means du by dx, and the rest of the functions you write as a product of du by dx. So v into w into d by dx of first function, that means u, plus in the first term, first function derivative we are writing and the rest of the functions product we are writing. In the second term, second function differentiation we have to write and the rest of the terms product. U into W and into d by dx of V. Plus in the third term differentiation, third function differentiation we have to write and the rest of the terms product. U into V into d by dx of w. Like this you have to remember easily the derivative of the product of three functions. I'll give an example. Find the derivative of the function f of x is equal to e power x into x square into log x. E power x into x square into log x. So here we observe that this f of x contains the product of three functions. So given function f of x is equal to e power x into x square into log x. Now differentiating with respect to x on both sides. D by dx of f of x. D by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of e power x square into log x. D by dx of f of x means f dash of x is equal to d by dx of product of three functions, go to this formula, u, v, w. So, v, w into x square into log x into d by dx of e power x plus d by dx, sorry, remaining functions is the second function we are differentiating in the next step. So, e power x into log x d by dx of x square plus next, third function we are differentiating. So, e power x into x square d by dx of log x, which is equal to d by dx of e power x is e power x. So, x square into log x into e power x. plus e power x into log x into d by dx of x square 2x plus e power x into x square into d by dx of log x 1 by x. So here x get cancelled. In every term, x into e power x, you have to take common. Possibility in this means you can take common, otherwise you can leave. X into e power x, if you take common, x into e power x means remaining x log x plus x into e power x, if you take common, 2 log x is the remaining plus x into e power x, if you take common here, will be 1. Therefore, f dash of x is equal to 1. I'll give one homework question.
You do what?
If f of x is equal to e power x, x square into sin x, x into e power x into sin x, then find dy by dx, then find f dash of x. Any doubts are there regarding this, you can write to my inbox. Thank you very much for watching my videos. Please do subscribe, and in the next episode we are going to do that problems based on trigonometry functions, d by dx of trigonometry functions, d by dx of hyperbolic trigonometry functions, d by dx of hyperbolic inverse trigonometry functions, d by dx of inverse trigonometry functions. The coming episode fully solving the problems based on trigonometry differentiation. Thank you very much for watching my videos. Please do subscribe.